JC here again. Today I want to talk about an element of cutting with the sword and buckler that I think is very important. Something that I don't see a lot of people doing and that I think is important. And that is trying to understand the simplicity of how the single hand sword with the buckler achieves its natural guards. Now what I mean is, if I don't have a buckler and I'm just cutting in a basic X pattern of diagonal blows and vertical strikes, and then I'm cutting across and I'm even cutting with the back of the sword horizontally and descending vertical or diagonal by putting my thumb here, putting that thumb on the lip of the cross and doing that, it's pretty obvious. But you put that buckler out there, and a lot of times people want to move the buckler when they're striking, which defeats the purpose of having a freaking shield in your hand in the first place. So what I just want to simply show is that rather than posing and statically moving through guards, that the guards are themselves organic and come as a direct result of what you're doing. For example, if I were to go cut, then my weapon is here, and my weapon can cut right back up again. If I were to go cut and turn it, then again my weapon is here, and I can cut right up, or cut around, or cut here, etc. If I were to go cut and bring it back here to cut again, you can see that, again, there's a natural organic posture or fighting ward that's going to occur. If I were to do this or to do this, then again, there's a natural fighting ward that's going to occur as I need on its own. It's that simple. So no matter what I'm doing and how I'm striking, my weapon can always be in a position to do all the different attacks that I need it to do. And my buckler doesn't have to move out of the way, and my sword doesn't hit my buckler, and I will achieve the different guards that you see with a buckler by simply striking in the different ways. Makes sense? It's going to occur on its own if you simply practice how to strike. Keep it in mind.